Is crypto mining a scam? So it's a question that you've seen flying around the internet many, many times. Is crypto mining a scam? Can people actually make money? Is there any truth in all of this? And the reality of it is categorically, yes, you can make money, and no, it is not a scam at its top level. Now, does this mean there are not scam companies out there who have set up with some invention of all sorts of crypto mining goodness and basically ended up disappearing in a tailwind as soon as they've stolen your money? Yes. So this is kind of where we need to separate these things. In principle, there is nothing wrong whatsoever with owning the mining device, mining coins, earning money, selling those coins into cash and earning a really nice profit. That is cryptocurrency mining. And if you're doing it in that method, there is simply no scam to be had. You own posh computer power. Other companies effectively pay you for renting out that power from you, and you get paid a reward for a service, the computational processing power service that you provided in a form of coins. You sell those coins on the market. Easy peasy. There is no scam. However, as with all things, wherever there's money to be made, there are disingenuous people who want to pull the wool over people's eyes. Now, unfortunately, what we've seen fairly regularly in this sector is that everyone kind of had the Bitcoin hype in 2017, 2018, where every man and his dog was talking about Bitcoin. And what that led to was loads of people wanting to get involved. And that obviously, that, you know, the overflow from that meant a lot of people wanted to get involved in Bitcoin mining. But the problem was the average person's education level was so poor that it left many, many people vulnerable to be taken advantage of. So when you talk about Bitcoin mining or cryptocurrency mining scams, what we're really talking about here isn't the concept of mining itself, because that's about as pure as it gets. It's bad players within that sector that are kind of taking advantage of people. So one of the most common forms that this took was something called cloud mining, where in theory you would buy a chunk of power off someone who had a massive warehouse of computers in another country, and you would kind of rent so much power off them per day, per week, per month in a long-term contract. And for many, many reasons, even though a lot of those companies were genuine, there was some of them that just weren't. And, you know, they would take loads and loads of money in payment up front, and then a couple of weeks later or a couple of months later, they would disappear. And, you know, these people would disappear around the globe without any track or trace. And ultimately, there's not much people can do about that. It doesn't inherently take away the principle of what's good or what's bad, so much as that people will always try to, you know, be disingenuous when there's money to be made. Unfortunately, that's the reality of human nature, and there isn't much that anyone can do about that. Now, when it comes down to how to safeguard yourself, then this is where it becomes a little bit more interesting. The reality of the situation is that there are lots and lots of ways you can make sure you're safe online, particularly when it comes to cryptocurrency mining. We would always advise people to never get involved with companies where you don't own the physical equipment. That would kind of be number one. There are many companies out there that say, hey guys, you can rent some of our mining equipment, you can rent some of our power. Well, that just doesn't make any sense, because if mining is so good, which it is under the right circumstances, why would anybody choose to rent you their power when they could be mining themselves if they've already got that kit and it's already set up? Doesn't really make any sense. Some people then throw that question back at me and they go, hey Josh, but your company sells mining equipment. Well, yes, we do, because we manufacture it. So it's a little bit different, because obviously we have our own facility mining as well, but the scale of this sector is so big, quite frankly, the more people that are mining, the better. I don't have a bucket load of equipment just sat there and my customers rent it off me. That's not the model we operate. The operational model that you should really be looking for is you own the equipment. You own 100% of the equipment. So God forbid you wanted to go and do something with that equipment a week later, that's your business and your prerogative. By owning the equipment, it also gives you full control over what coins to mine as well. Because if you've bought equipment and you're forced to mine a certain coin, then that's silly. There's no need to be kind of bent over a barrel there. With your coins, your equipment, you taking 100% of that, then it really limits any type of vulnerability that you have in terms of any company taking advantage of people. So here at Easy Crypto, for example, people often ask us, well, okay, Josh, that's great, but what if your company disappeared tomorrow or something happened to you and you got hit by a bus? Well, quite frankly, that would not affect any of our clients' ability to earn any money. It's their equipment. they can access the machines remotely. They have full control over what the devices are mining. Simply, we come in to give the best advice that we can. So if I'm not around, I might not be able to give that advice, but ultimately the equipment and the earning potential remains identical. So irrespective of where my company is, everyone who has equipment currently is still gonna be just fine. Now, when you kind of think about getting involved in this space, these are some of the things that you need to take into consideration. If you spend tens of thousands of pounds with a company in another country and that company goes bust, what chances do you have of any type of fallback? You don't own any equipment, you're not really in control of it, you can't go over there and pick up the equipment. So again, it's just like all investments, it's something that you want to be sensible about. So are there vulnerabilities in this? Are there people looking to take advantage? Yes, there are. As the kind of interest in Bitcoin kind of fell from its peak when it was $20,000, thankfully that's become a little bit less, and now the stronger players have come to kind of stand the test of time. But the reality of it is crypto mining is about as honest and as pure as any type of business service that you can imagine. Similarly, many of you watching this now might own a business or at least be familiar with how web hosting works. If you have to pay a monthly web hosting fee to rent the computational power to keep a website online, you would never say that the web hosting company is a scam, because you appreciate you need to rent computer power. That is pretty much what's happening in the crypto mining space. Computational processing power is a resource. Other companies need that resource and are happy to reward you for the process of doing so. So at its core, it's as pure as it gets. Above that, unfortunately, people are not always the nicest in the world and will take advantage. So again, one of my big goals for the sectors when I'm keynoting and running my business here is to educate people across the sector to understand what the pitfalls are, so people can make the right decisions for them, whether or not they should get involved or not. I hope this has been helpful and helped answer the majority of your questions. If you have any other burning questions for the crypto and mining sector, have a little look around our channel and we'll look forward to being able to answer some more of those soon.